My topic today's agenda also, research report format. What is a research report format? I'm having the dissertations of the last batch students. So this is, you're seeing here, this much a page, and they have some kind of binding. So the binding is there, as well as they're keeping some kind of structures to follow to write the research report. So this format only we are going to talk now. So I hope you are able to see me. Now my agenda is to teach the research report format. That means only I'm going to start now. Okay, so can I go for, are you able to see my dissertation? Yeah, yes. Okay, thank you. Yes. Now see, this is a MA dissertations. This is my scholar dissertations. Don't think that this much a page, don't be panic about these things. Okay, so even some of the PhD thesis may come with 30 pages only. So based on the types of the research, maybe differ the content as well as the pages. So that's why don't worry about the things. Yeah, so my agenda of today's research report format. Research report is nothing but the end of the day or end of your research work, you are going to submit the documents. So what you did, so what are the research attempt you did, everything you can compile, and you are submitting as some kind of document. That document is called as a research report. But the research report is not easy. We could not be go with like our own kind of style, we could not be adopted. So normally we are following the APA, American Psychological Association format only we are using. That format only I'm going to talk about now. So in what are the report, what are the components are there, what are the sections are there, according to the APA guidelines, that's only I'm going to talk to you now. Yeah, the first thing, what is a research report? Normally the research report is a research document that contains basic aspects of the research projects. So this definitions we know, this is a basic definition. So report is a research document. So when we can submit the research document, after end of our all our research work only, we are able to get the research documents that contain basic aspects of the research projects, what we did, that we have to be added into research documents. Yeah, see the case of research report format. So before going to the research report format, just I'm going to incorporate the three terms. So already we discussed for the once again, for the understanding purpose, I may talk about these things. One is called research proposal. So the research proposal we may submit before the starting the research work. Before starting the research work, we can go with this kind of proposal. So the research proposal means like a action plan or pre-plan what you are going to do. That is called proposal. Then after the proposal, we are going with the synopsis. So what is a synopsis? The synopsis, I'm going to write this, start from the synopsis where we can submit in this one. After finishing all your research work, the entire research work, the summary, you are going to give us a small document. It's like a small, nearly 25 to 30 pages small document. It's nothing but the summary of your entire reports, what you did up to now. That is called synopsis. Normally the synopsis, before submitting your thesis report, we are submitting the synopsis. So it means that normally the PhD level, before the 6 months, we have to submit the synopsis. The end one is called as a research report. So the research report is nothing but the final document. It's not a summary, it consists of all. So what it did till now, what is your tool, in what manner you did the research, what is your output, what is your findings, what is your conclusions, everything we may highlight in the research report. So this is the way the research sequence may go. So the first one is called research proposal. Before attempting the research, it's like an action plan, it's like a plan of actions, what you're going to do, that is called proposal. Once you submit the proposal, you are going to do your research. The end of the research, you feel that, okay, so I finished everything. Then you have to compile some kind of summary report. That summary report normally we may submit before in the university, before 6 months of the entire document to submit it. So that is called synopsis. Then finally, normally in the synopsis submission, the PhD level we tell the term as a pre-submission seminar. So when the students are giving the pre-submission seminar, they may highlight the findings, they may talk about the entire research, in what manner they attempted, everything they may highlight it. that time the faculty member, they may give a lot of input, even the other scholars also may give some kind of input, they may criticize, they may give some positive things. Then based on the critics, based on the positive aspects, they may be changed a little bit in the research work. Then finally, they may submit as a research report. This is the final output. So the final output of your research work is the research report. That only I'm going to focus. What are the sections it may incorporate or it's needed for writing a research report? So the first phase is called preliminary sections, main section, and reference section. So we have to divide our thesis or the dissertation into three sections. One is called preliminary section. Even the same for the master degree as well as the PhD also. What's the preliminary sections? So what are the things that comes to the preliminary section? That I'm going to be talked one by one. Then main section, what is the main section? So main of your work, we may incorporate in the main section area only. Then finally is called as a reference section. So we may add some kind of appendix, bibliography, everything is come to the reference section. So this is the three sections we have to look on it while you're writing a report. Just I'm going with this. So what are the things that come to the preliminary section? The first section I'm going to talk about. So what is the preliminary section? What are the components or what are the things may come under the preliminary section? So these are things should be covered. Come to the preliminary section. One is called cover page. So it's nothing but the first page or the cover page that may be preliminary sections. Then title page, certificate, declarations, acknowledgements, table of content, list of tables, list of figures, sometimes some things having some kind of abbreviations. Then some are previous report, they having this kind of summary report, small summary report or one or two page summary report they may add. So this much of things may come under the preliminary sections. So I hope you understand this. Preliminary in the sense, only that first two phases. First phase is what we have to add into the thesis report. That is called preliminary section. Just I'm going to the one example of our MET dissertations. From this I'm going to start. So just you can look on what are things this comes to the preliminary section. I'm going to discuss this one. Yeah, see here. I'm going to be open the thesis, one of the students' thesis report. She is compiling the report like this. Okay, so we can be compiling a single file, the entire research report, but she is making us a Kavita leaf, Kavita certificate, Kavita content. So actually the certificate and content, these two things may come under the preliminary page. The chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, chapter 5, this is called as a main sections. The 8th and 9th, like references and appendix, may come under the reference section. I hope you understand the order. So the leaf is nothing but like a leaf. Each chapter we are keeping some leaf. Actually, that is not, that's why I put as a zeros number. It won't be there. It's like we can insert that pages in the each chapters. That's why I'm using the term zero. But normally, these first two, certificate as well as the certificate in the sense, what is the first page, declarations, then cover page, everything I put in a heading like this much. So don't think this only certificate may incorporate. For the heading purpose, I'm keeping like this. The contents also may come to the preliminary. The first two things I may talk to you now. If I open the certificate, see here what are the pages are there. These pages content we have to incorporate while writing the research report. So in the preliminary section. The preliminary section, the first part, see here, this is your title. Normally the title should be in a two line or a three lines, in a two lines or three lines, but it should be a premed, reverse premed. So normally you don't type like this. So this is wrong. So for example, don't type the research title like this. It is wrong. Because according to the API style, it is showing that it should be a two or three line, but the line alignment should be like a premed. It's like a premed, but in a reverse premed. See this case, this first line P, the end lines, yes, sir. But if you look on it, that downward, the paragraphs as a down sentences is not be above the first paragraph, it won't be go away from that. So it means that it may comes inside that one only. For example, if I want to go with this three line, just I'm going with this towards online examinations. Just I'm going to be convert like this. Yeah, so it may goes like this. So the topic, we can go with this kind of pyramid shape. I hope you are getting the pyramid shape, the reverse pyramid shape only you have to type the topic. But parallel, you have to look on the data. Word also, postgraduate attitude towards online examination, Kasaragod district. But if you go with attitudes in a single word, it should be good. But there is no spaces, that's why we can go like this. So this way only, we can keep the title. Actually, this total page is called as a cover page or a title page. So I hope you get it. The title page or a cover page may consist of the title of your research work. Just I'm going to the back. Yeah, title of the research work. For the MR level, we may use the term dissertation. For the physics level, we may use the term thesis. You have to highlight which degree you are going to do it. Then give the investigator name. Then guide by. In down, we have to add the university emblem. Then university college department details. In down, you have to write here May 2020 or April 2020. In which month you are submitting thesis? That should be there. So this is called cover page as a title page. After the cover page or title page, we have to give the declaration. What is the declaration? Normally, the declaration means the declaration is to be given by the scholar, or the student. So what they going to declare in the sense, this is a topic. So see here, I do here declare that the dissertation end title submitted to the department and so on. This word important has not formed on the basis of for the award of any degree or diploma or associate or fellowships or similar title, any candidate of any university or institution. So we are giving some kind of declaration that it should be given the research scholar only, or the research student. They are given some declaration. This topic, no one can attempt it before me. And this is a topic or this is a research area. No one used for getting award of any degree or diploma or fellowships. It means that this topic is a unique, I only attempted research. Like that you are giving some kind of declarations or authentic declaration you are giving. This is my report research work. No one can adopt, no one can publish the same report before me. That kind of report you are giving as a declaration. That is the second part. Then after the declarations, we have to add the certificates. Normally the certificates may be given by the guide. So the certificates given by the guides, even my name is there. What the guides may given, this is the same kind of things. This certify that this is a topic done work done by the Kavita for the purpose of Master of Education the year, like that we are giving. But this term is important. So here he is also what he is giving. The dissertation is her original work. So she is not copying it anywhere and has not previously formed on the basis of award of any candidate. So this kind of research work, no one can award in previously or getting the degree in the similar titles. That kind of small certificate the guide may give to the scholars. Then this so-called certificate page. I hope you are getting. This is called cover page. Then this is called declarations. It should be given by the scholar. The next is called a certificate. This is given by the guide. Then after this, we can go with acknowledgement. What is the acknowledgement? The acknowledgement is nothing but the like thanks. So we have to give some kind of acknowledging to those who are supporting to a research work or supporting to a research work. We are giving some kind of acknowledgement. That acknowledging is called as here. They put as a term as an acknowledgement. So normally we can give the acknowledgement. There's a structure is that. So we have to give the university VC, then HOD, then guide. So that kind of sequence are there. So that things you have to follow. But only the thing, we have to keep, give the acknowledgement those who are helping to your research work. So don't, so if you want to satisfy some of your family member, uncle and brother, don't be write the names. If they damn sure they're helping you in the sense, you can add it. It is not a, some people's what they're doing, they are dedicating the research work to my mother. They dedicated my research work to my sisters. So it is not like dedication your research work to someone. It is a research work you had to dedicate to the society only. So you don't use the word dedication. Dedication, you can write for the book, that's okay. But for the research purpose, a research, you don't use the word. Some people, they are using their photos of their parents and they put the term, say, I'm dedicated to the research work, my scholar, my mother, from the grandmother. That kind of things won't be there in the, don't be incorporated in the research work, because it's truly a research work. The research work, finally, it may reach the society only. So it means that the research work, what is the ideally to work the research work in the sense, for the benefit of the society only. Therefore, don't give your research report for dedicating to someone. That is not ethical. So this is called acknowledgement. But the acknowledgement should consist, those who are helping to you, that people only have to give the acknowledgements. This also may come to the preliminary section. Preliminary section in the sense, before starting the, before writing to write in your research, the documents, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, we are adding some kind of preliminary sections information. That information is called as a preliminary section. So for this, these are the components needed. Just you can look on it. One is called cover page or a title page. Cover page and title page look like the same only. Then declarations, then certificate, then acknowledgement. After this, we have to add this also. What is this content? So the content is nothing but the, so what is the chapter one? What are the headings are there? What is it? So this kind of content. See, normally the entire content, the what's the first chapter, second chapter name, what is the page number? And these things we can incorporate in the each chapters before. Each chapters before also we can incorporate, otherwise we can be added before the chapter started. That also is permissible. But normally we are using only this one, only the before the chapters. Then these are the things we are adding before the each chapters. For example, this page I may use only the chapter one before, and this page I may use in only the chapter two page report before. This page I may incorporate in the chapter three before I may add this one. But these two things, like list of tables and list of diagrams, see here, list of tables and list of graphs, these things you have to be incorporate after the acknowledgement. After the acknowledgement, you have to incorporate this kind of tables number, then page number, list of graphs, figures. So this is all is coming to the preliminary section. This is all is coming to the preliminary section. Once again, I'm going to make PPT slides. Now we have get some kind of input about this. See here, the preliminary section consists of cover page. So the first page I told, no, the title, in down the investigator name, in down the guide name, that year, that is called as a cover page. More or less the cover page and title page, because if you look on the cover page, just so you can see the camera, just so you can see the camera, this is a cover page. So this is like here, she's binding the hard binding. In the hard binding, the same cover page is making some kind of color printout. The same cover page only, it's the first page. It's the first page as a report. See here, she's adding the first page as a report. So she's keeping the first page. I hope you are able to see this page. Yeah, so cover page and title page look like same. Then after this, if you look on it, it may come to the certificate page. Then after this, declarations. Some people, they may change ulta, declaration, certificate. Then acknowledgement, table of contents, table of list of tables, list of figures. From the biggest level, they are using the abbreviation. Suppose I'm using the title e-learning. Everywhere we are using the e-learning. Like that, if you're adding some kind of abbreviations, we can use the list of abbreviations before starting your chapter one. E-learning means electronic learning. If you are giving some kind of abbreviations, if you are using abbreviations somewhere in your research report, we have to give the exact descriptions about the abbreviations before starting the chapter one. Then page level only we are using one page abstract or two page abstract. Now I move to the second section. So what is the second section? That is called main section. That is important. That section only talking about the entire research work of our scholars or the students. The main section consists of the five chapters. The chapter one is called introduction or a conceptual framework, but some university they are going to six chapter also. Based on the university, it may change. But our university, we are following only five chapters only. Some of the universities like Tamil Nadu, Alappa University, they're going with six chapters. So it will be different based on the university that we have go with this. The chapter one is talking about introduction as well as the conceptual framework. So here, these are the title we have to incorporate in the chapter one, like introduction or conceptual framework of study, need and significance, purpose and scope, statement of the problem, definition of the terms, objectives of the study, hypothesis of the study, assumptions, limitation and characterization. So these are the things we have to look on it while writing a chapter one. Just I'm going to give some kind of input about the each terms. So what is the conceptual framework of this? For example, I am doing a research related to the online examination. I want to check the attitudes of online examinations to the PG students. That is my study. So what I have to do in the conceptual framework, I may give some kind of information related to what is the online examination. Then when the online examination started, what are the online examination the students are doing now? That kind of small preliminary input related to a topic we have to write in a concept framework. Then the main thing this is we have to look on, that is called need and significance of the study. So need and significance of study in the sense, what is the need you are adopting that topic? We have to give the justification. So normally when you go for Viva examination also, the examiner may ask the questions, why you are select this topic? So we are giving some answer. That answer should be incorporated in need and significance. What is the need and significance to adopt this topic to do the research work? So that kind of thing is called as need and significance of the problem. That we have to, based on the topic, we have to give the justification. What is the need? What is the necessity? What is the significance to adopt? To do the research work, that you have to give us a need and significance of the problem. You can give the 3 paragraph or 4 graph. Then the next thing, some other people are adding this one also, purpose or scope of the study. So after doing the research, what is the purpose and what is the scope of? What is the scope while you attempt this research work? What is the scope you may get it? That kind of things you can give us a paragraph, 1 or 2 paragraph. Then statement of the problem is nothing but the title of the study. Your title of the study had to be emphasized. This is my title. And even the people, they wake up in the midnight, you should tell the exact the frame of your title. Even if some people asking my PhD title, I will tell the title without giving any spaces. Because it may memory, it may blending with my blood. That kind of, what is that? That kind of spirit I did that research. The same thing. You also may do it if you are having the research attitude. Always in the 24 hours, you may think about the research work only. But normally in the research report, the statement of the problem is nothing but our title of the research we have to emphasize. Then definition of the terms. People are using a different kind of terms. Some people are using a definition or an operation definition. Definition means you can give the definition, someone gives some definition about the online exam. For example, in the case of, I'm talking about the attitude towards online examination. So here, what is the key term? Attitude is a key term. Online examination is a key term. For this, if you are giving some definition, then it's called definition of the terms, the two terms. Instead of that, you are giving a operation definitions. Like you are defining what you're going to do for this. So here the attitude, you are giving the definition, attitude is nothing but feeling or opinion about the online examination we are going to measure in based on some scales. So that kind of definition as a researcher they are providing the sense, that is called operation definitions. Then after the operation definition, you have to highlight the objectives of the study. What is your main purpose or main objectives of your research work? For example, the topic, I'm doing this topic as a attitude towards online examinations among the PG students. Here, what is the objectives? To find out the level of, to find out the level of attitudes of online examination among the PG students. That is my objectives. So that kind of objectives you have to frame for based on your research work. The next one is called hypothesis. Normally the hypothesis is called as tentative assumptions. So that's why some people are using hypothesis or research question also. Both is, if you are using research question, no need to go with hypothesis. You can adopt anyone. even some of the research work, no need for the compulsory for hypothesis. Like if you go with the historic research work, only the objective is enough, no need for hypothesis. Only the hypothesis need, only if you go for the experimental method or survey method. Hypothesis is nothing but a tentative assumptions of your findings. Tentative assumption of finding. For example, I'm going to I'm doing the online examination attitude only, you know. I have some kind of assumption that there is a significant difference between boys and girls in the attitude towards online examinations. Normally, if you look on the types of hypothesis, lot of types are there, like null hypothesis, alternate hypothesis, then question form hypothesis, declarative form hypothesis. Better you can adopt a null hypothesis. So it's like we are going to find some kind of assumption, what the findings may come. That assumption we are going to take it as a consideration for doing a research, that is called hypothesis. Then after this, we have to add limitation, delimitation of your research work. What is limitation, delimitations? So for example, I already mentioned that my topics is measuring only the PG students' attitude only. So what is my limitation? I am limit only for the PG students. I'm not taking the UG students. I'm not taking the PhD students. Only I'm taking the PG students. And I may measuring only the online examination. I'm not talking about the e-assessment data. So that some limitation may be there. That limitation we can focus. What is your limitation or the limitations? Then finally, in the chapter one, we have to add the chapterizations. So what is the chapterization in the sense? What is the chapter one? What is chapter two? What is the chapter three? Telling these things may come to the chapters one. Just I'm opening the chapter one of the students, then you may understand what are the things is needed to write the chapter one. So just I'm closing this one, I'm coming back to the chapter one. So see here, the chapter one, chapter two, chapter three, chapter four, chapter five, everything is called as a main session. So I'm opening the chapter one. If you're opening the chapter one, writing the chapter one minimum, I think more than 30 pages. So we will see. So she's writing 31 pages for the five chapters. It's not custom. There is no control for going with this number of pages. You and your guide can decide how many pages you want to go with this. That is your concern only. See here, the chapter one consists of framework. Then she's writing for each title, she's giving you 1.1, 1.2, 1.3. So this is, she's going to write here. The topics is adapted to attitude towards online examination. Therefore, what she's using, see here, introduction, so related to the online. Then she's talking about some of the higher education, because she selecting the sample as a PG student, that's what she's telling. Then after this, she's going to assessment evaluations, different types of assessment evaluation, examinations. So see the structure, how she's coming, different types of examinations, then classification examinations. So then mode of communications of examinations, advantage of examinations. Then she's talking about the examinations only. So after the examination, she's coming with online examination. That kind of structure, like a simple to complex, or some kind of sequence may be there. Then online, she's coming with 1.5 as an online examinations. Then she's highlighting the history of online examinations. Then she's highlighting the types of online examinations. Then responsibilities, advantage of online examinations. Everything she added, so some bodies to organize the online examinations. Up to this is called conceptual. Up to this is called conceptual. So up to 1.5, she's adding this one. See here, just I'm opening. Conceptual framework of the study, she's adding up to 1.6. So it's having nearly this much pages. It's like a brief introductions about your topic. The conceptual things you are going to keep clear picture to the layman. So actually, when you look on to the research work, the layman, for example, I'm the layman. If I read it, I can understand what is an online examination. For that, you have to give the entire answer for this. That is called the conceptual framework. After this, what she adding? Need for the study. I already mentioned this is the second part of the second important components in the first chapter one. She can give the justification why she adding or she doing the research or attempting the research of this title. See here, she's giving more than 3 pages. She's giving some kind of justification. So as a assessment of company of e-learning, she's giving, if you look, read it, you may understand. Then finally, she compared it finalize with. Therefore, the primary aim of this research is to obtain the first-hand. So she's citing as first-hand information postgraduate students at to see assessment. In this concept, attempting the study of attitudes online examination among the students watching. Therefore, the investigator will plan to do a research work and attitude towards online examination among the postgraduate students of Kasaragod district. So this is one point. This is called need for the study. So after the need for the study, what is that here? Purpose. So only the piece level, only the adding purpose and all. If you need, you can add the purpose. The next one is called statement of the problem. The statement of the problem is nothing but the title. The problem of the present study was entitled as postgraduate students of Kasaragod district. Then after the statement of the problem, so what we have to need next is called definitions. Definition means any one definition we can give it. But if you are using the term operation definition, the operation definition may define only the investigator only. So she is giving the term operation definition. See here, in the operation definition, she is highlighting that what is online examination. So what is my attitude? What is my postgraduate? So given the definitions, so attitude denotes the tendency to respond positively and negatively towards a certain idea and objects or situation. Here the attitudes of online examination stated the tendency to respond positively or negatively towards online examination system. This is defined by the investigator. So if they defined by the investigator itself, we can use the term operation definitions. The operation definition, from that itself, we can understand what you are going to measure. Very simply we can understand it. Then next is called objectives. So see here, after this, objectives of the study, she's dividing to general objectives or specific objectives, but you can go with a single object. You can go with only single term like objectives of the study. So she is going to rate the PG students based on the level of the skills of computer users. Actually this is general, but she is going to do this is your main objectives. Her main objectives to study the level of postgraduate students of attitude towards online examinations. So she is finding some other component as well, that's what she is using. But this is enough to study the level of postgraduate students' attitude towards online examination, then to find out whether there is any significant mean score of attitude towards online examination and postgraduate students with respect to gender. This kind of objectives they have to write it. So then after the objectives, we have to go with hypothesis. So hypothesis. So if you go with hypothesis, see here, normally the objectives may start with the two to find out. But in the case of hypothesis, may start with the there is no significant. There is no significant difference in the mean scores of PG students or back towards online exam with respect to gender. See, using a null hypothesis, therefore she used the term H0 represents null hypothesis. She's using nearly 13 hypotheses to check the hypothesis testing and all. Then after this, we can go with limitation and delimitation. So in her thesis, she forgot to add the limitation and delimitation. That's why she's skipping. So for the thesis level, it should be incorporated, even the MA level also, but she forgot to add it. Then after this, we have to go with chapterization. So the chapterization is nothing but, what is it, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, chapter 5. So what is the chapter 5 consist, chapter 3 consist, everything you can give it. This description. So then finally one conclusion for the chapter conclusion. This is for chapter 1. This is also part of the main components. I hope you don't have any doubts at all in the chapter 1. I move to the chapter 2. What is chapter 2? It is chapter 2 name is called review of later literature or review of later studies. There is a two terms they are using. Literature means if you are adding any kind of essay. So there is a two terms. Literature represent, you can add any kind of news article, or you can add any kind of book article. Parallel, you can add some studies also, like research studies also if you are incorporating. If you are blending all kind of reviews, then it's called review of later literature. But if you are focusing only the research article, we can use the verb review of later studies. So papers are using different manner, but the PG level you can go with review of later studies. It consists of this much. One is for studies related to the foreign, studies related to the India. Then we can give the critical review and gap identifier. So what is foreign reviews in this one? For example, I'm taking the consideration as an example for online examinations for PG students. So what she wanted to do, the researcher, she can add the foreign studies which are already existing, which are already did the related to the online examination or e-assessment, that she may highlight. Then parallelly, which are the Indian studies, which are the people have studied the same kind of research work in advance previously. Then critical review. In the critical review, we are comprising what is the, how many foreign reviews, how many Indian reviews, in what are the methodology they are using, in what sampling technique they are using, what is the findings, everything we are look onto on some kind of critical review. Then finally, in the critical review, we are came to the conclusion that no one can adopt the same title as it is. So for example, she is doing a research on an examination of PG students in Kerala. So after verifying all the three things, she may give the answer that I summarized more than 500 or 50 research work, but most of the articles is talking about the e-assessment as an examination, but no one can find out the attitudes. They are checking the other things. Even some people said did the attitude also, no one can check the attitude towards on an examination for the PG students, postgraduate students. That is why I am selected as a research work for doing a further doing a research. That thing here to give us a gap identifier. So these are the four things we have to look on it when writing the chapter 3-2. Just I'm going back to the chapter 2. So one of the thesis report I'm showing to you. Yeah, I'm opening the chapter 2. See here, this is a chapter 2. So it's adding the chapter 2 in 31 page this also. Chapter 2 review of later pages. So he's using the introduction. This is basic. Okay, this is not considerations. Types of source of reviews. He gives some kind of information, what is the importance of reviews and all. But this from this one, it's important. See here what she's adding. Review of later pages. See, using the review of later literature, but normally we can classify into two, foreign literature as well as the Indian literatures. She's compiling both in this case. See here, Khan and Khan 2019, they did their study. This is the report findings. So each paragraph for each one, each paragraph is denoting each studies. Then second study, Patreons. So when you're writing this study findings from my existing one, we have to keep the APA format also. There is a format, it's called citation. When you write a proper citations, we can keep it in APA 7th version also. So it's like each reports. So she's giving the each study reports, each paragraph is showing the each study. So like this, she's giving more than 50 studies report. So she's making a different paragraph. Each paragraph is talking about unique studies. So then end, so I'm skipping because everything same only, that research report. Then end, she is giving the term critical review. So in the critical review only, she is finding the research gap also. See here in down what she is giving, the final, I am going to compile the final work. Yeah. By referring these like previous studies, it also tested significance based on the demographic variable and presence. We also found out the significance when comparing attitudes on demographic variable, and also so far no significant demographic variable. Like that, we can give this justification, no one can adopt it, that's why I'm adopting this research work. So we have to give the, so it helps the investigator. Like this is giving the small gap identification. For this is giving the some description also. So why she, in what manner had said is unique, no one can adopt it, that's why she attempt to do this work. So see here, the review of literature will provide a clear understanding of the earlier finding and description of the topic with the research took for the present study. Based on the understanding of the previous research, the investigator planning to fix the desired sample. Actually, it's like a plan from the reviews of the other people only. We can get the clear picture about what we are going to do. That kind of pictures we may get it from the previous studies related to our research work only. That's why we have to look on the second chapter properly. We have to write second chapter properly. Yeah, so now I hope understand what are things come to the second chapter. Now I move to the chapter 3. What is the chapter 3? So what are things come to the chapter 3? See the chapter 3, this is called chapter 3, design of the study methodology. This is important. Normally, if I am the examiner, I may concentrate more in the third chapter, fourth chapter, and fifth chapter only, because that topic, that chapter only is talking about the research work carried out by the researcher. So she may, even the researcher may give the descriptions of the research design. So you may go with research design, like study, survey method, experimental method, historic, anyway, but you have to give some research design, what research design you are adopting. Then we can highlight what is your sample, what is your populations, which sampling procedure you are using. The last semester you are studying the the probability sampling, non-probability sampling, that kind of sampling and things you have to give the descriptions. Then in what manner you are getting the data, what are the tools you are using. That pilot study is nothing but the pre-survey. So before doing a final survey, we had to do a pilot study for small people to validate your, or to check the reliability validity cost, as well as to doing the item analysis with your pilot study. Then item analysis, reliability validity. These are things when you go for the next classes, I may emphasize much what is the item analysis, reliability validity and all. Then after this data gathering procedure, then statistical treatment which you adopted for the fourth chapter. These are things you can add in the chapter number 3. And just I'm going to come back to the chapter 3 views. Yes, I'm clicking the chapter 3. So I hope you understand that the chapter 1 to chapter 5 is coming to the main session. Yeah, the chapter 3. So we already mentioned that introduction is not an important main thing here. She may start from here only, the methods, yeah, from the research design only important. What's the research design she's using? She's using a survey method. See here, and she's describing the research design with some diagram representation also. What is the survey method? What is her variable? What is the tool? What is the sample? What is the statistical technique? She's using some kind of conception map or flowchart to expand her research work. Then after this, she's talking about the populations. So her population is PG students. Then we have to go with sample. So what sample she's using? She's using a 750 sample in a random procedure. That we have to talk in the chapter 3. Then tools, which tools she's using for collecting the data. Now she's highlighting the construction of the tool. From this only we are giving the what is by reliability, what is by validity, then item analysis. She's highlighting the item analysis also. She's adding item analysis. From the item analysis, she's removing some items. She's keeping, she retains some items. Then finally, she's giving the reliability score, and then split of methods she's adopting. Then finally, how we can, after finalizing the tool, what she did, how she's organizing the data collections, then what are statistical techniques she adopted. So t-test, percentage analysis, t-test, ANOVA, chi-square. These are the things we can compile in the chapter 3. So these are the headings we can add in the chapter 3. Yes, so when you look on deep about the reliability validity, that time I may emphasize the entire process of how to do it. Item analysis, that's I talk about later. The next, the chapter 4. So chapter 4, what it's, okay, what are things needed for chapter 4? Chapter 4 consists of statistics techniques like descriptive or differential statistics. Then we can go with text to with appropriate tables and figures. So this four chapters is important. When you go for the quantity research, all that you have to add a lot of tables, you have to like add some kind of graphs. If you're going with the quality, you can write in the quality based report without the number. That also the same thing, but only the in the quantity research you can use the statistical part. For the quality people, they can write in here critically analyze the report of your work. So report, critically analyze the things which you observed, which you did, that you have to write in a qualitative manner in the chapter 4. Just I'm going to skip and come back to chapter 4. These are things you have to look on to write the chapter 4. So the first one, see here one more thing. Descriptive statistics means preliminary statistics, which are the statistical techniques used for describing the samples, then we can use the descriptive. Differential, to get into the, as normally we are using the term inferential analysis also, like higher level calculations, whether the male are better than the female or rural are better than the female, that kind of differential analysis, we can go with this. Then finally, based on the table description, we can write up the text with appropriate tables and figures, we can add it to the chapter 4. See, the chapter 4 of her is 34 page. So she's adding a lot of tables in this. She's adding a lot of tables. So only for introduction she added, then she's going to be deeply about the statistics part, description. Yeah, so the sample descriptions. So she's giving a very good picture about statistics part. If you look on it, even the figure. So based on the above tables, she's giving the figure representations. Then it goes like a 34 pages. So she's adding a lot of tables, like she did a percentage analysis there. First is the descriptive statistics. So these are the objectives analysis in a percentage analysis on the CI compact. So this also percentage analysis. What's coming? So yeah, so this also percentage analysis, but item wise percentage analysis. She's doing a percentage analysis for item wise. So she's having the tool now. From the tool, she finds for each statement how many strongly agree. Then for each table we have to give that. So she's adding some kind of percentage analysis, and down she can give the description with the colorful graph also. So this also descriptive. So she's adding some kind of histogram, whether we can go with the normal public curve, whether we can go with the parametric or non-parametric statistics. For this using, she's checking the histogram diagram. Now after this is moving to this is called differential analysis or the inferential analysis, like t-test, f-test, chi-square. So when you go for even these things that Joser may talk about, what's the t-test, f-test and that. Otherwise, if time possible, I may also add it, because these things, the statistics part, it's come to the second unit also. Second unit and third unit having some kind of statistical input in our this semester. Yeah, so like that, she's adding this much of tables. So this particular chapter consists of tables, numbers, then interpretations, then a graph. So this is important. So this is like a findings. Your findings you are giving is numerically she's presenting. Yes. Now after the fourth chapter, so what it's there. Okay, if you go with chapter 5, this is like a summary, the report of the entire the 3 and 4 chapter. Normally the people's, no, even the chapter 5 things, they may use it for the SNAMCIS purpose. The entire SNAMCIS also it may replicate here. Restatement is the problem. Already we are adding the first chapter statement, that's why we are using the term restatement. Then we can give the small summary about the work we adopted in the 3rd and 4th chapters. Major findings based on the 4th chapter. Then what is the interpretations? The discussion is nothing but we have to compare with our findings with our reviews. We already have reviews, no? We have to compare with this. Then conclusion of your research work, then recommendation for further investigations. And this is come to the chapter 5. Just I'm going back to the chapter 5. So I'm opening the chapter 5. So if I'm opening the chapter 5, we may get into the chapter 5 description. So here, so he's using a chapter 5, 16 pages. So like introductions, reaction of the study, like need for the study. It's like a small summary of the 3rd, 4th chapters. Then finally, the end of the 5th, we may add some kind of new things like discussions, the education implication of the study, then further research. These are things we are doing. The same, the first chapter objectives, hypothesis we are adding. The main thing we can add is a summary findings. Based on the 4th chapter, we are adding the findings with interpretations. Then after this, we are going to recommendation for further research. So those who are seeing this one, you can give, as a researcher, you can give the further research to elaborate your research work. You can give the suggestion for others to continue this research work. Then you can go with the education implications of the topic, which the study of your research work. Then conclusions. These are things come to the chapter 5. Then I hope you understand the two sections still now. We are discussing the two sections. One is called preliminary section, other one is called main sessions. Now I am moving to the reference section. So what is the reference sections talk? The last sections, in the reference sections, it's nothing but your bibliography as well as your appendix. So bibliography, the second chapter, we are adding lot of citation, no? All the citation reference should be added in the reference part. So we are using, there is a difference between the reference and bibliography. So while I have the time, so tomorrow I may talk about the difference among the two later. The appendix is like add-on. So which are the things like your tool, you have some kind of document proof. When you're doing the experiment, you have some kind of photos. No? That kind of proof you can add it in the appendix part. These two things, bibliography and appendix, may come into the reference sections. These two is come to the reference section. Just I'm going to the last sections, that 8 and 9. So the reference is nothing but bibliography. So there's a small difference between bibliography and appendix references. Reference means which are the citation you are adding to the chapter 1 to chapter 5. For that only, that name, so citation, reference only we are given this, and that is called references. But if you are adding other than that, other than the citation, you are referring some of the books, material, you are reading some research articles. From this also, you understand how to do the research. That also you want to highlight as a references, then you can use the bibliography. So if you are adding, if you are, for example, the citation, 20 citation. If you are adding as here, the end part of a reference, only the 20 references based on the citations, then it's called references. But you are highlighting 20 citations, but at the end we are giving 40 reference things in the sense, then you can use the word bibliography. So she's using bibliography, but it's using the APA 7th format. That also I may highlight later. So what is the APA 7th questions talking? Then this bibliography. So after this bibliography, we have to go with one more thing. That is called appendix. Just I'm going to the appendix also. Yeah. So the appendix consists of, only the tools. What is the tools he's using? That letter, the tools, things. Even we can add the master table. Then this is the tools he's adopting. That's what he's adding this one. Even you can add some kind of photos for proof to do that experiment. That proof also you can add in an appendix. So this much things we can incorporate in the reference section. Reference sections. Yes. So I hope you are getting to the all the things. Just I'm going to compile all the things. The research report consists of the three sections: preliminary session, main session, reference session. Preliminary session consists of cover pages, certificate page, then declaration, acknowledgement, then contents. If you look on the main sessions, all the chapter 1 to chapter 5 is come to the main sessions. The reference section consists only the two headings like bibliography and appendix. These things may come together. This is adopted by John W. Best research book. He given this kind of format. Then the preliminary sections consist of this much of components. The main section, 5 chapters. Each chapter is having their different heads. Maybe the chapter 4, chapter 5. Then the reference section consists of two things. One is called bibliography. The second one is called appendix. But in the end note, we are not using. So because we are using APA format, if you go with the English, like language-based research, those are using a lot of format. That's like MLA format, Chicago manual. Some people are using end notes, but we are not using that one. That is called reference sections. Okay. Yeah, thank you all. I hope you understand how to write a research report. So what are the sections we have to be incorporate while writing research report. Thank you. Jai Bharat.